In this video on Google Earth Pro, we explore My Places. These videos were made possible by America View, Virginia View, the Virginia Cooperative Extension, Colorado Mesa University, and Virginia Tech's College of Natural Resources and Environment. Funding for this project was provided by the United States Geological Survey under grant number G14AP0002. The contents of this video and the related written tutorial are solely the responsibility of the authors and do not represent the official views of the U.S. Geological Survey. Mention of trade names or commercial products does not constitute their endorsement by the United States government. This video accompanies Section 7 of Chapter 3 in a written tutorial titled Exploring Our Planet with Open Source Software. You can find the written tutorial at virginiaview.cnre.vt.edu/education or at americaview.org/exploringourplanet. Google Earth Pro has two table of contents. We discussed the default table of contents in two other videos. In this video, we will discuss how to use My Places. What is My Places? This is where you create a map using your own data, either existing data or creating your own. We discuss using existing data in videos on KML files and GIS shapefiles. Here, we discuss creating your own data under My Places. You can create your own point data by adding a place mark. You can do this in one of three ways: by using the icon on the icon toolbar, by going to the word Add and then clicking on My Places, or right-clicking on My Places in the table of contents and clicking on Add and then Place Mark. But the first thing you have to do is search and zoom into a location. In this instance, we are searching for the Louvre in Paris. Once it is zoomed in, you do see that it does have a balloon over the Louvre as an icon, but this is not located in the table of contents. Now let's add a place mark, and you can use any of the three methods we've already discussed. Once you add a place mark, you get a new place mark dialog box and is highlighted in the map document window. You can change the name to the Louvre by typing in the name box. Then you can click on the color box and change the color for both the label and the icon. Once you click on a box, you choose your color from the color palette. Your new colors show in the dialog box and the map document window. Now don't click OK yet. You do have other options within this dialog box. We're not going to discuss these here. We're just pointing them out to you. You can experiment with these on your own later. But there's two other options: view and altitude. We are going to discuss the description tab. So go to the description tab. Here you can add web links for information, online images, or an image on your computer. After you find the URL and put the URL in the link URL box, you click OK next to the box and the URL adds to the description box. Again, you can do those both for add web images and add local images. You can also change the type of icon. You click on the icon, which is a push pin in this case, which is at the end of the name box. You get a symbology dialog box. And once you've chosen your icon, you click on OK. And the icon changes in the map document window and in the table of contents. You can now click on the name in the table of contents, and the information that you added with the links will pop up in your map document window. If you right-click on it in your table of contents, you get options. We've seen options similar to this when we discussed KML and GIS files. We will discuss save in just a minute. We're not going to discuss the other options in this video. You can explore those on your own. You are not limited to one placemark. Here, we've added a second placemark for Notre Dame. Now we're going to discuss Save Place As. Again, you right-click on the name to get the list. Go to Save Place As. Then you will get this window where you navigate to on your computer where you want to save it. Name it, and now it is available for you to use at another time in another map document. So we've added a point. Can you add a line and a polygon? Yes, you can. You can use in one method with the ruler. If you want to remember how to use the ruler, go back and see the video on measuring on how to use this tool. But after you're done measuring, what you do is you click on the Save button. You will get a box where you can name your new line. Then click OK. You can do a circle, and you can do a polygon. Each time after you've done it, you clicked on OK or Save, and then all of them will show up in temporary places in your table of contents under My Places. You can right-click on any one of those new layers that you created and click on Save to My Places or Save Place As so that you retain this for use in other map documents. Now, if you click on Save to My Places, which is what we did for the circle that we created, it actually now shows under the My Places table of contents. It's moved from your temporary places up to under My Places. We end the video here. You can explore other options on your own. If you have any questions with regards to this video or the written tutorial, please contact Dr. Tammy Parise at Colorado Mesa University or Dr. James Campbell at Virginia Tech. The email addresses are shown on the screen.